In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Father of the poor. Come, source of all our store. Come within our bosoms, shine. You of comforters the best. You the soul's most welcome guest. Sweet refreshment here below. Bend the stubborn heart and will. Melt the frozen, warm the chill. Guide the steps that go astray. Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome again, my dear brothers and sisters. We are recording this video from the church, from the chapel where we have the candles, because here we have this image of the Sacred Heart of Jesus. I've chosen this place because today's two gifts refer to the heart. Help us to love God as He deserves. And as we just prayed with the sequence of the Holy Spirit, these two gifts come to melt our hearts that many times are so stony and give us a love that is like a Christ love, like the love of His heart. And talking about the gifts of piety and the gift of fear of the Lord. These two beautiful gifts that I'll explain in a second. Both perfect virtues. Remember, once again, the virtues help us in our moral life, but require an effort. When the gift comes, it perfects and makes things much easier. The gift of piety comes to our heart and moves our hearts to love God with the love children have for their parents. Many times we have a dark idea of God, or a God that is distant, a God that is very demanding, a God that is always upset with us. This gift comes to heal our hearts from that harshness, and then opens our hearts to tenderness toward God, and consequently towards our brothers and sisters as well. This tenderness is a sincere, filial attitude, the attitude of the children toward God, which is expressed in prayer. It's rooted in their own personal experience of their own poverty, their own need, the emptiness and the emptiness of the earthly things. This experience arouses in the soul the need to go back to God, the need to find in Him all our happiness, and turn to God for help, for forgiveness, for love. St. Paul expresses this very beautifully in the letter to the Galatians, which he says, God sent His Son that we might receive adoption as children. And if you are children, it's proved by the fact that God has sent into our hearts the Spirit that cries, Abba, Father. If you remember, Abba is the word that Jesus Christ Himself used in the Gethsemane to address His Father in an amazing expression of confidence. In this gift, we're saying, perfects the virtue of religion. Religion is the virtue that teaches us, based on justice, to give God what He deserves. But it could be a little bit too poor, like saying, okay, God deserves worship, God deserves honor, God deserves obedience, but I do very much like a soldier nowadays. God doesn't want just slaves. And Jesus told the disciples in the Last Supper, I don't call you my slaves, I call you my friends. The second part of this gift, as we were saying, is this tenderness and openness, charity with one's neighbor, and which is manifested in meekness. Blessed are those who are meek, because they will inherit the land. There's a new capacity to love them, not always because they're perfections, but because they are the children of our Father. In the love of God, we can love others. And then this gift extinguishes all bitterness, anger, impatience, and nourishes feelings of understanding and tolerance and forgiveness. It helps us to build the civilization of love. Beautiful example of this gift in action is the life of Mother Teresa of Calcutta. That tenderness, love she experienced for the poorest of the poor. Second gift that we talk about today is the gift of the fear of the Lord. It sounds a little bit strange to consider fear as a gift, particularly with God, because we remember the experience of Adam and Eve, that when they committed sin, they were terrified, and Adam says, we were afraid, and we hid. Or the servant in the gospel that was entrusted with one talent, and instead of producing, he was afraid, and he hid in the ground. It's not this kind of fear we're talking about. And the Bible has a beautiful expression of how the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. The fear of the Lord that perfects the virtue of penance. The virtue of penance is the virtue that helps us to reject our sins and be unhappy with our sins. The gift of the fear of the Lord is a sincere and intrepid feeling that the man experiences in the face of God's amazing majesty, incredible majesty. Particularly when we are reflecting on our own infidelities, and then when we reflect that, as the Bible says, we can be found lacking in the good deeds in front of the eternal judgment, from which nobody can escape. The believer stands before God with a contrite heart and a broken heart, because of our awareness of the many offenses and our own imperfection. And then, as St. Paul said to the Philippians, we have to work for our own salvation with fear and trembling. Not as an irrational fear, but with a sense of fidelity to God's law. This gift of fear of the Lord is based on love, and it's based on the truth and an awareness: who is God, who are we? On one hand, we, of course, we are aware and we are sad of our sins. On the other hand, this gift brings us that awareness of His divine mercy and His fatherly concern for our fate. It's a filial fear. It's the fear of the child that doesn't want to offend the father, doesn't want to betray so much love. It's a fear of committing sin. It's a fear of separating ourselves through our actions from God, who is love. This gift generates a lot of Christian virtues, like humility, temperance, chastity, and be able to control our senses. The one who has the fear of the Lord is a person who is not slave to the senses. And it keeps always as a warning in our head, saying we are accountable for our actions. So it's a very, very useful gift. Beautiful example of this gift, the practicing, was Saint Maria Goretti, this 13-year-old girl, Italian girl, at the beginning of the 20th century, had in mind those words: "Better to sin, it's better to die rather than sin." And then she was absolutely opposed to any kind of sin. And when that neighbor tried to force her and induce her to sin, and then she resisted to the point of being a martyr, point of being slaughtered by him. She died shortly after in the hospital for giving him. It's a beautiful example of the gift of fear of the Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. So, just a note, many of these catechises have been taken, inspired by the addresses of St. John Paul II in 1989, Regina Celli and the Angelus. We're working on translating them, and we'll put them in our website. God bless.